Hello, everyone. Hello. Wow. All right. That is so funny. It literally flew. All right. I guess I am supposed to talk about this today. Even my phone is excited. Hello, beautiful people. I wanted to stop in today to talk about the two types of people. And just in my line of work and helping others to connect to their higher self and the environment, and also working on that level of soul, I've noticed, and we're kind of like talking at just the beginning of it. We're going right to the beginning of it because I'm gonna come back and talk about the different layers too. But today we're just going to talk about so coming down duality, the two dualities, and I'm not talking about male female. And so the two types of people. What I've noticed is that there are two types of people. One of them, well, one has really mastered what it means to be on this planet, what it means to be grounded on Mother Earth, and the other has mastered the connection to spirit. So everything spiritual, they've mastered it, they get it, they've grounded into that. That is like your normal. So that's the physical and the spiritual beings. And what this means is that, the one that is really grounded into earth, hi Lorena, the one that's really grounded into earth, they get it. They're the ones that love to go hiking, they climb mountains, they do rock climbing, like earth is normal for them. That is like a comfort zone. So, for example, my partner is Earth, is the physical. He's mastered that. He's very comfortable hiking, like he's very agile when he's walking, and he never falls. He can never trip. You should see him on ice. Like he just slides right on there. And I am, for example, I'm the spiritual. So me on this earth, like hiking, like I take my time because it's not my norm. It doesn't feel stable for me. Like the spiritual feels stable for me. Where for him, earth is stable. It makes sense. He gets it. His body is grounded in it. It's very powerful to watch earth beings. And then spiritual. So let's come back to using me as an example. Me hiking with him, especially when we're crossing one of those, we come across a river and there's a, like, let's say a tree over the river, and that's what you're supposed to walk over. It freaks me out. Like, it's like, oh my gosh, I'm supposed to walk over that. I'm totally gonna fall. And he just gets on it and just goes right on and just stands there like, are you coming? I'm like, just give me a second. Let me just prepare myself. And I would take my time, like walking on there. But the thing is that it's not comfortable for me. Now, if we were to talk about sitting in meditation, channeling, I'm like, yeah, bring it on. I get it. I see it. Let's do it. The connection is quick. I just close my eyes, boom, I'm there. For him, if we're going into meditation, he has to prep himself. He has to sit in the right position where, he will be switching back and forth because it's uncomfortable. He has to like bring in that aspect of breathing. Like he had, there's a whole preparation for him to really tune in there. Like it's harder for him to tune into the spiritual realm, anything high up there, because he is that grounded. Now, here's the thing. Here's the magic in this, knowing which one you are. And like I was saying, this is just the beginning of it. So today I want you to focus, which one are you more comfortable with? And it's not to say one is better than the other, because it's not like that. The goal, the magic in this is knowing which one you are. And also that we need to be balanced in both. We need to be both physical and spiritual. So by knowing which one you're comfortable with, you're able to also know which one you need to work on. So for me, my partner, I'm very lucky. My partner helps me with that. So he helps me with that grounding aspect. He, you know, like I go on walks with him, I go on hikes with him, and I watch how he interacts with his environment, and I learn from that, you know. But I know that is that's the area that I need to work on. So now when I'm walking, when we're going on hikes, I do barefoot so that I can really connect to my earth. And he teaches me, like he'll be like, if we're climbing, you know, like somewhere steep and there's a rock, he's like, use your hands and your feet, like crawl on there. And that like helps me to really connect to the earth and found my stability on the earth. And so this allows you to really find out which one you are, which one is like your home, the home base, the part that you're comfortable with. And then which one do you need to work on? And that's the key in this, because we do need to be both. We need to be masters in our spiritual and also masters in our physical. And so knowing which one needs more work is very important so that you can start bringing more energy in there. For me, spiritual is very natural for me. I'm very strong there, just like my partner is very strong in the physical. And so we balance each other in that way. And that's the other thing. If you're in a relationship, and I'm not just talking about love and, you know, like a love partnership, but also friendships, family, you know, kind of look at them and see which one they are and which one you are. Because when you're interacting with others, where their home is, where they're comfortable, is where they're gonna meet you at and how you're gonna interact. And so for me and my partner, in a loving relationship is perfect. It's a great tool to use because you can learn to balance each other out. So when we go hiking, I know that my partner is literally running up the 14 is where I am literally crawling up. But I'm able to tap into his energy. I'm able to tap into that strong earth foundation and use that to motivate me to climb that 14er. I draw on his energy to climb that 14er. Just like if we were doing a meditation or anything spiritual, he would tune into my energy and use that to help him be lighter. The other part of it is that earth beings or the physical beings, which I'm talking about like the types, people who have mastered the existence on earth, they're the ones that tend to fall into depression, withdrawal, and that's because the earth energy is heavier. It is so much heavier, and it's so easy to get stuck and twisted into all of that, the drama on this planet. They tend to be very in tune with what goes on this planet, and they get very upset with what is going on with Mother Earth because they're very connected with Mother Earth. And so, you know, like the pollution, the, you know, seeing someone throw a cigarette butt on the street, like all of that upsets them because this is their home. This is their home base. And anything that affects your home base affects them. And so they tend to really be drawn down, you know, like pulled down into the heaviness of this space, of this matter, of this earthly plane. Where the spiritual beings, the ones who have mastered their spiritual connections or the spiritual realm, they tend to be flighty. So not grounded, just kind of like here all the time. You know, you're talking to them and you're not sure if they're listening to you or if they're somewhere else or daydreaming. They're not really grounded. They're just all up here. So do you see how we have to be both? And in a way that you don't have to switch. So if you're spiritual, it's not about switching into physical. It's about meeting in the middle and being grounded in both. You're being grounded in both the physical and the spiritual. And what this looks like is, let's say, for a spiritual being. So I'm going to use myself as an example. Now, before I come on here, or before I channel, or before I do readings, I actually ground myself. So grounding is very important to me. Grounding is very important to all spiritual people who have mastered that spiritual realm, so that they can really bring down or channel what they need to bring down to speak out. But it's in that grounded state so they can actually relate to you. So when I ground that information that comes in, what I'm talking about right now, when you listen to me, you're able to really grasp it. You're able to apply it into the physical realm. Where if I was just all up here, I mean, you'd just be like, what the heck is she talking about? I have no idea. You know, like it just doesn't make sense. Unless you're a spiritual being, then it makes sense. But if you're earth and you listen to a spiritual being who's not grounded, it just looks like they're jibber jabbing all the time, you know? And then, and so the reason why this information is coming in for you today is to find out which one have you mastered. Have you mastered the spiritual realm? Have you mastered the physical realm? And if so, which one do you need to work on? Do you need to work on the physical, which means you're grounding more, you bring in the elements of the grounding, bringing down, you know, that spiritual, the spiritual qualities, the spiritual gifts, and grounding it into your earth? Or do you need to work on the spiritual, which means that you have to learn to connect and trust this, but not stay here, but bring it in conjunction with your earth and ground it in. So it just it's all coming. It's about bringing those two together to create a whole. They're not separate, they're whole. They're coming together to balance you, to bring you wholeness. So that's the key of this. That's another thing that was coming in. I think that's gonna go to the next one. So we'll see what there's like a series of it coming in, but today we're going to start with physical, spiritual. Which being are you? Which one have you mastered? Are you a spiritual being, which means you've mastered the spiritual realm? That makes sense to you. That is your home base. Anything and everything spiritual, you get it. Or are you a physical being, which means that anything that happens on this realm, you've got it. You've mastered it. Oh, the other thing is that the spiritual masters, so the people who have mastered the spiritual realm, they're the ones that are really good spiritual teachers. So you get the gurus, you get even the monks who can go and sit and meditate for days. You know, they've mastered that realm. They know how to connect. They know how to pull what they need. That is a spiritual master. An earth master is basically, they're the ones that they're successful, they're usually rich, you know, they get the abundance, you know, they understand that whole concept. You know, anything physical, like manifestation on the physical level, they get it. They get it. When you're out of balance and you're more spiritual, you get it up here, you're very abundant up here, but you don't know how to be abundant on this earth. So if you notice, most spiritual teachers, most spiritual beings need to work on that aspect on themselves, like how to manifest that abundance on this plane. It's very important for them. Where if you get that, the earth part, and you've manifested, you know how to manifest your world. Then now you need to connect the spiritual and bring it in so that you can even bring more value, bring more meaning, bring more purpose into what you've manifested. So it's very important to have both and to be balanced in both. So, spiritual being, physical being, which one are you and which one do you need to work on? Go ahead and comment below, and I am looking forward to reading it, and I will come back probably. We'll see. We'll see what I'm guided to do, to talk about the next one. I love you. Mwah. Bye.